For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now. With nothing but time on our hands and new films and shows dropping with alarming frequency, we were bound to fall in love virtually. Here are our 10 crushes of the year. The fictional characters who made us smile, swoon, and get through a bleak time a little more lighthearted than we were before. Mara is handsome and resolutely stubborn in his ambition to build a low-cost airline. But he's also vulnerable. We see him cry and rage at the world in his frustration. But most of all, Mara is secure enough to celebrate his wife's success and lean on her when he's doing badly financially. Now, what more can you want in a man? Abbie Hoffman was perhaps the star of the Chicago 7 trials, and as played by Sacha Baron Cohen, he combines fierce intellect with a laid-back cool that is superbly sexy.
I call this portion of the trial with friends like these.
Especially in the key scene when he asked the lawyer interrogating him to give him a minute because he has never been on trial for his thoughts before. Just wow. Anya Taylor-Joy is a remarkable actress in many ways. But the one thing that truly defined her performance as female chess prodigy Beth Harmon in The Queen's Gambit was her unbroken gaze. She has the largest on-screen eyes we've seen, reminiscent of the unique paintings of Tim Burton's Big Eyes, which almost made it seem like she was burning a hole not just into her opponents, but the viewers on the other side of the camera too. Vikram Seth's A Suitable Boy had Kabir, whose only unsuitable quality was his Muslimness. He was charming, intelligent, well-built, and is the sort of character that's easy to fall in love with. In fact, many would argue it was necessary to fall in love with him only to experience the heartbreak more painfully. It's kind of rare to watch a female protagonist eat unashamedly on screen. Women are usually captured in the kitchen, toiling and flicking away the sweat from their brows. But Bommi feels real. She doesn't believe in being a passive and voiceless member of the family. She runs a bakery successfully, which isn't an easy task, and even helps her husband see the light at the end of the tunnel. It's purely a give-and-take relationship that she's interested in. She's a dream girl, but not a manic pixie. We guess it is kind of wrong to announce a crush on a film character who's shown as a victim of patriarchy and objectification by men, but it's hard not to succumb to Tripti's charms as Bulbul, who has a killer combination of open-faced innocence and a bewitching smile. It also happens so that she's totally comfortable sharing a bidi at night in the Rajwadi courtyard dressed in rich Banarsi sari and heavy jewellery, which she carries off stunningly. We think Gabrielle from Emily in Paris was especially crafted for the pandemic to add some much-needed beauty to this god-awful year. What's there not to like about the hot French neighbor who's kind, lets you use his shower, cooks you fluffy omelets, and looks like a dream? He doesn't have too many layers to his character, which just adds to his perfection. Yes, he's also kind of cheating on his beautiful girlfriend, but let's just ignore that for now and focus on the good. Varanne Avashamundu is not Kalyani Priyadarshan's first film, but it's perhaps the first to show us her true range as an actor. She anchors a character that could have easily become a series of clichés with nuance and subtlety. But beyond the heft in her performance, she's a delight to watch on screen, especially when the scene is funny. Her voice is one of the reasons for this. When she speaks and when we listen, she sounds like a friend, but you quickly want her to become something more. Yes, she's pretty, and yes, she's smart. But she also comes across like loads of silly, pointless, laugh-till-you-cry fun. Ted, the wet in Schitt's Creek, Alex's on-and-off love interest, brought a certain sense of warmth to the screen.
I'm Ted. I'm newly single. And I'd be kidding myself if I told you that I haven't wanted to do this every single day for the last 2 years.
If you're feeling down in the dumps and looking for a pick-me-up, he's the kind of realistic dream boyfriend you should definitely stumble upon. Amongst a sea of testosterone-fueled hot-headed men in Bijoy Nambiar's Tesh, Arfa was the moral center, fighting rage and revenge with compassion and empathy. Arfa is smart, charming, and far too good for the men she's surrounded by. She wants nothing more than a simple, peaceful life away from the chaos around her. And you want nothing more than to be able to give her that.